Due to illness and unavoidable scheduling conflicts, the role of Joshua Braze will be played in this episode by Jamie Rees instead of Sanger Steele.
I've been struck in that flint and steel. I've been stirring up the flames. I punish you for all the pain I feel when I'm the one to blame. Gonna cut you down to size. Overlook the pain in your eyes. Digging and stubborn as a mule. Losing love, lonely as a fool. I'm gonna burn at my own stake. I've been struck in that flint and steel. I've been stirring up the flames. I punish you for all the pain I feel when I'm the one to blame. Now I'm getting that everything I asked for. Burning under my heart's desire, wearing my crown of fire. Gotta make a sacrifice on the altar of always.
Facebook conversation between Stefi Warrack and Astrid Bracken. Sent 8:15.
Right. The only reason I'm telling you this is because you're big in Allure, and so maybe she'll listen to you. But yes, I'm really worried about her. To be honest, I've not really felt secure in our friendship since first year, but I don't think she's too proud of the person she was back then. I think the way she sees it, back then she was a whimpering mess who needed me as a shoulder to cry on. And I think it's quite painful for her to have those memories because she's such a strong, amazing person now. Anyway, now she's drawing lines all over the place, which I guess is a substitute for using me to piece her together, and it seems to be working, I guess. Like, she can take on more stuff than anyone I know, but when she's on the stuff, she becomes completely manic and only cares about herself, and I don't know what to do about it. I've obviously thought long and hard about sending you this stuff because obviously it's quite sensitive, but can you please try and bring it up with her? She needs help, and if I've started reminding her of the bad times, I don't know where she'll get it.
That's awful, hun. Really awful. I hope you're okay. You can talk to me anytime. I'll bring it up with her when the time's right. Maybe this Saturday. I think she's having a...
Friendsgiving.
Friendsgiving, that's what I said.
I'm not sure. It's such a busy week, and I'm not even American.
But half the Allure Committee is, and I'm pretty sure you wouldn't object to them taking part in Oktoberfest. Besides, it's all the rage on my Pinterest right now. What?
I haven't heard you talk about your Pinterest since, like, first year.
I know, it'll be just like first year. You and I haven't planned something together in ages. And you know we're the dream team.
Friendsgiving!
Love you, babe. Oh, P.S. There's one more thing.
Yeah?
So don't step out or anything. Like, there's gonna be loads of people there, but I'm inviting Nathan.
No.
Calm down. He hangs out with the Allure crew, and even you can't deny he's good for a laugh. It'd be weird if I didn't invite him.
It'd be weird if you did.
I get that this is a bit of a conflict, but could you put this aside in the spirit of Thanksgiving? Pilgrims in Indian style?
I can't believe you're asking me to do this.
Okay, I get it. What if I promised to sit by you the whole time? You won't even have to look at him. Please, I really need my best friend's help here.
I don't even have to say hello.
If he comes near you, I'll chemically castrate him.
I guess that's all right then. Friendsgiving.
Yeah, like Thanksgiving, but...
Yeah, for friends. I understand what it is. I just don't understand how it's any different from regular Thanksgiving.
When we move in together, I'm going to make a penalty jar for every time you're boring like this. You're worse than... Never mind.
Things are still bad with your flatmate.
Yep. I'm just avoiding her now. She legit followed me into the union the other night when I didn't respond to her messages.
What?
To be fair, I think she was trying to apologize, but she's being such a creep about it. I wish I had a different roommate.
Same with mine.
Josh isn't your roommate.
He's a cold fish at any rate. At least Abigail is funny. Remember when she asked if she could be the Velma to your Daphne?
No, she's bright, but she's not a nice person.
Dana reflected for a moment how completely wrong Mia was and how quickly she'd change her tune if she had to swap her roommate for Dana's. Mia, meanwhile, was thinking exactly the same thing, but reversed.
Anyway, Friendsgiving.
Sure. As long as Joshua and Abigail aren't there.
Friendsgiving?
Yeah, I know, Josh. Sounds gay. But it should be a good laugh.
Should be a good laugh was Nathan's rationale for doing most things, from sleeping around to starting fights, to adopting an academic son with nothing in common with him but a habit of irresponsibility.
Yeah, sure, I'll come with.
Of course you will, Josh. I knew you'd never break the bro code. That wasn't what I was talking about. Steffi's going to be there.
No problem. I won't speak to her. I wouldn't, don't worry.
I wouldn't be worrying if I hadn't heard about you stalking her in the union the other night.
I wasn't. My friend Mia was there and I just wanted to speak to her. I didn't know Steffi was going to be with them.
You wouldn't lie to me, would you, Joshua?
Never.
Fair enough. I think Mia's going to be there, since it's an allure thing.
In Nathan's mind, Mia was one of his cast-offs. He liked the idea of Joshua chasing his cast-offs.
Great. Of course.
What happened last night, by the way? You went straight into your sad drunk phase last night. Usually you go through angry drunk stage first.
Yeah, no, I'm fine. It's just... So my mum called me and her and my dad are getting divorced.
Great! Ethan and I can crash at your dad's bachelor pad. Dope!
That would have been funnier if Josh could have been entirely sure that Nathan was joking.
Abigail, raise your sign higher! Hey, hey, ho, ho! Corporate greed has got to go!
This is embarrassing, Angela.
Are you kidding? You said you'd be here for our cause, what the hell?
Look around, nobody should. The only thing you're achieving is making sure that the employees spit on your produce. This is silly.
I can't believe you.
If you wanted to make a real change, why didn't you call your representatives or sign a petition or vote like the average citizen? You could have at least set up a table like the other societies in town.
You know, if calling your representatives and voting changed anything, why do you think they let us do it?
Who the hell are they?
The 1%. Banksters! The one oppressing the proletariat!
I'm sure that the CEO of Tesco will be calling you shortly to congratulate you, but until that happens, I'll be down the street at India's Thanksgiving party. Last chance. Do you want to come with me? Maybe give her a piece of your mind?
You really think you're going to convince me to abandon the struggle just to get in a bitch fight with India Rayner?
2 hours later...
I can't believe you dragged me here, Abigail.
It won't be that bad. My roommate Mia's here. She's one of the models. Hey, Mia. This is Angela, my academic mum. And you... Your name's Josh, right?
Abigail?
Hi.
If Joshua recognised the girl he'd pushed outside the union on his first day, he was far too busy trying to keep an eye out for both Steffi and Nathan to pay much attention. For her part, Abigail was too busy trying to work out ways of making Mia like her again to pay much attention to the sulking shadow next to her roommate.
So, is everyone enjoying this vapid ritual of consumerism?
Oh my god, it's just a holiday!
Yeah, one that celebrates the slaughter of thousands of Native Americans.
Jeez.
What? Am I ruining your Genocide Day celebrations?
No, I just think that you're killing the mood a little.
Wow. Privileged much?
Abigail had wanted Angela to come to this party with her purely because she didn't want to go alone, but she was suddenly grateful for her academic mother ensuring Abigail wouldn't be seen as the most annoying one in this conversation.
Jesus, Angela.
Anyway, I didn't come here to exchange pleasantries. I'll see you later. I've got to find India.
Sorry, she can be a bit much.
Josh, come with me. I'm going to the snack table.
Can I come?
Abigail, I swear to God, leave me alone.
Bye.
Astrid, have you seen India anywhere?
Angela, you're here.
Yep. I'm here to talk to India about her shafting me from the Allure Committee.
I don't know if this is really the time and the place for...
Well, she won't respond to my messages, but that's fine. Maybe you can explain to me what the hell happened there. You're on the committee, you should know.
What?
Well... I don't see her here. You're the committee secretary, which means you've been in on it.
Look, Interview wanted you out. I tried to stick up for you. I really did, but...
Oh, piss off. You've never tried to stick up for anything in your life.
That's not fair. I couldn't do anything. You know what India's like, and...
I'm not sure I do know what I'm like, Astrid. Maybe you'd like to tell me.
India, you're also here.
Hello, India.
Happy Thanksgiving.
I'll leave you guys to it.
You're not going anywhere.
Oh, but I've just seen...
Cut the crap, Astrid! You've clearly got a lot to say about me, so you're going to say it to my face.
Are you just going to ignore me, then?
Oh, I'm getting to you.
I swear, I'm going to...
What? You're going to what?
Guys...
Shut up, Astrid! Look, I'm trying to enjoy myself tonight. I really am. But you've just waltzed in here trying to turn my committee against me.
No, I came in here looking for answers.
Answers? Here's an answer for you. You're a joke. Nobody takes you seriously on the committee or off it. You're the girl who expects to end capitalism by picketing a multi-million-pound grocery chain. You're sad. Show yourself out.
This act you put on is what's sad. You forget I knew you in first year, and...
Hey, guys, take a volume down a notch. What's going on?
You're apparently the only person on the committee who doesn't think I'm a monster, Stefi.
Classic St. Andrew's meetups, then. Angela, I've actually been looking for you. You know, it's the story you used to tell about the monkey and horse.
Yeah, why?
Hazel wants to hear it. I've tried to tell her, but I know you'll tell it better. Come with me.
I'm busy.
Come on, please, please.
Oh, fine. This is not over, India.
Great. Bye, guys.
I'm also going to head.
I've already told you, you aren't.
Look, India, I was just humoring her, I promise. You know what Angela's like. Maybe you should ask Stefi about...
Stefi is an angel. Don't you dare try and put this on her.
She said much worse about you than me.
You're lying. Shut up.
Well, I don't want to be dragged into this, but if you're asking me for evidence, let me just get out the Facebook messages you sent me.
I'm not interested. I'm not...
Yeah, so we were talking about you firing Angela, and she says, yes, I'm really worried about her. That's you, by the way. And she says, to be honest, I've not really felt secure enough friendship since first year. Blah, blah, blah. Back then she was a whimpering mess who needed me as a shoulder to cry on, etc., etc. Now she's drawing lines all over the place, which I guess is a substitute for using me to piece her together, blah, blah, blah. She becomes completely manic and only cares about herself. Also, apparently you talked to...
Okay, right, shut up. Let me see that. Jesus, I mean, you've taken stuff a bit out of context.
I just didn't want to read out all the boring parts. Cut the crap, as you would say. She didn't tell me this stuff out of the goodness of her heart. And India, you know I'm the last person to stir stuff up, but you saw how she reacted when you tried to speak to her just then. And you saw how keen she was to speak to Angela. Why do you think that was?
She doesn't like fighting, wanted to defuse.
Do you really believe that?
Right, you can go. I've got to speak to someone important. Here's your phone.
Hey, Joshua, hey. I'm not sure you remember me, but...
Sure I do. I ran into you outside the union on my first day here.
Ran into is a cute way of... Never mind. Have you seen Mia anywhere?
Nah, she went somewhere.
She told you not to tell me where she is, didn't she?
Not gonna answer that.
Huh.
How have you been?
Great. Fallen in with some stressful people, though. What about you?
Shit. Fallen in with some great people, though.
Yeah, Mia's really nice. How did you end up as her date to this party?
Oh, long story. We had a falling out. I tracked her down at the BOP last week and apologized to her. She said that was really sweet and asked me to come.
One part of Abigail told her that Mia couldn't have told Joshua to say that too. Another part told her to throw her flatmate to India Rayner and not look back.
That's weird. I followed her into the BOP last week to apologize too. Sounds like we've just been running around each other's shadow without realizing.
Guess so. Oh, there's my academic dad coming towards us.
Oh God. I had a bit of an awkward hookup with the guy he's with.
Josh!
Hey, Nathan.
Who's your flat-chested friend?
That sounds like my cue to leave this super uncomfortable conversation. I'll see you later, Josh. Bye, Will.
That was rude, Nathan.
It's called nagging. She's wet for me now, guaranteed.
Nah, don't do that, Nathan. You too, Josh, actually. She's very clingy.
Hey, man. It's not really like that with us. We're just friends.
Calm down. Why would I care anyway? We just hooked up one time.
Oh, shit! That was anonymous union girl?
Yeah, she's kind of crazy, though. She insisted on staying over, and then the next morning she was just like, oh, I really like you and stuff.
Yikes.
Nathan, you're here.
Well, India invited me.
Can you come to India's room for a second? She needs to ask you something.
Ooh.
Sure.
I better get back to my friends.
As I've said multiple times before, we're your friends, Joshua.
So, Nathan, sorry to take you away from the party, but I have a serious proposition for you.
You're propositioning me?
Shut up, you know what I mean. You might have heard that Angela resigned from the Allure Committee.
I heard you gave her the boot.
Details. Either way, the position is vacant, and I think you should take it.
Don't you have to officially open nominations or something?
You know those are all just formalities. If you want the role, it's yours.
I'm not sure.
What's wrong? You applied for it last year.
Stefi. Might be awkward.
Ugh. Stefi is a drama queen, and she'll get over it. Besides, she's been with loads of guys since you... In my opinion, she's lost the right to care.
Really?
Yeah, she's so over it. And so are you, right?
Right. Yeah.
Right. So I don't see why it would be an issue. So do you want the position?
I'll think about it.
All right, I'll take that.
Let's get back to the party.
Stefi, you're here.
Yeah, sorry I'm late. Did I just see you and Nathan coming out of the bedroom together?
It's not what you think.
And what am I thinking? That you're talking to him about the Allure Committee after you specifically said you wouldn't. I'm not an idiot, India.
Steph, calm down, you're being crazy.
Sounds like something Nathan would say. Enjoy your Friendsgiving. So I'm starting to wonder if you ever had any friends.
You've just proved to me that I don't.
What?
Goodbye, Steffi.
Mia!
You know, I wish you'd been this keen to talk to me when I was interested in being your friend. Which I was, by the way.
Look, you've made your point. I'm sorry. I'll be different.
Abigail, I want to believe that. But we've lived together for months and you're not even trying to change. So your assurances are more or less worthless to me right now.
Look, there's stuff going on, right? And I can't tell you about it. But if I could, you'd understand.
Of all the lame excuses you could have given Abigail, that's maybe the lamest. I'll see you back home.
I'm telling the truth! Mia?
Steph, wait. Do you have a second?
What do you want, Nathan? What could you possibly want from me?
You never showed for that coffee. What's wrong?
No, don't touch me.
Why not?
Because you and me, together, are a mess, Nathan. A really big mess.
I know we are.
And I'm trying to move on. As hard as I can, I'm really trying. Fine, I'm a mess by myself, too. Fine, I've been sleeping around a little. I'll be the first to admit. Maybe I was trying to prove something. Or maybe... Never mind.
Or maybe what?
Maybe I was just trying to feel something like I felt for you.
And did you?
Of course not. It doesn't feel like this with anyone else.
For me neither. Steph, you and me...
are something really special. Yeah, I know. But we're also a giant mess.
And
we're not good for each other. You're not good for me.
So where do we stand?
Right now? We're standing too close together.
I can't help it.
Me neither. Nate, we just... I mean... We can't be together.
But we can't be apart. You know I love...
No, don't.
What?
Don't say that word, Nathan. I've spent the last 2 months convincing myself every day that you don't care about me.
Steph!
We're serving turkey now, if anyone wants it.
Bye, Nathan. I just can't with all this.
Steph, wait!
Just let her go home if she wants to. She's been so weird recently, right? I don't know what her deal is. So, have you had a chance to think about my offer yet?
Yeah, sure. Why the fuck not?
You'll take it? Oh, gorgeous! We're going to have so much fun. You know you were always my first pick for the job.
Whatever.
so I'll text you?
Sure.
I've been struck in that flint and steel. I've been stirring up the flames, burning under my heart's desire, wearing my crown. Yeah, I've been struck in that flint and steel. I've been stirring up the flames. I punish you for all the pain I feel when I have no one to blame. Now I'm getting that, I'm getting that. Everything I asked for, burning under my heart's desire, wearing my crown of fire. Burning under my heart's desire, wearing my crown of fire.
This episode of Citizens of Nowhere was written by Isabel Bousquette and Claire Fenerty, and edited by Claire Fenerty, Hermione Budd, and Jamie Rodney. Sophia Anderson played Abigail Bell, Anna South played Stefi Warrack and Dana Richardson. Jamie Rees was Joshua Brace as an understudy for Sanger Steele. Holly Scrivener was Astrid Bracken, Lucy Beal Lott was India Rayner, Ellie Laurence was Angela Murray. Catherine Montana was Mia Bridge, Alana Foster was Siobhan Kennedy, Andrew Johnson played Nathan Livingstone. Nathan Lovelace was Will Balfour. The narrator was played by me, Kiera Obi. Due to illness and unavoidable scheduling conflicts, the role of Joshua Brace will be played in this episode by Jamie Rees instead of Sanger Steele.
Maybe you need to leave, 'cause I'm getting drunk on your noble deeds. It doesn't matter that they don't get done. When I feel this cold, they're like the fucking sun. Baby, I need a friend, but I'm a vampire smile. You'll meet a sticky end. And here I'm trying not to bite your neck, but it's beautiful and I'm gonna get so drunk on you and kill your friend.
Thanks for taking me out for lunch, Angela.
Of course.
What a... I can know it mother's for.
You look exhausted. Were you out in the line for Christmas ball tickets all night?
Oh, I was there, but I wasn't in line to buy tickets.
Were you...
I was protesting against the overpriced, elitist nature of the whole thing. Can you believe they're charging £45 a ticket? And for what? Don't get me started on...
So, were you successful? Did anyone flee the queue and promise to change their capitalist ways?
Well, I thought I got some people to leave, but then they came back for coffee with them and their friends, so...
You know...
I really thought the protest would work. I even considered trying to buy up all the tickets so nobody could go and they'd have to cancel it.
Didn't quite have enough money in your bank account?
No, they only let you buy 8 tickets at a time. So, you're not going, right?
No, I'm not going. You're right. £45 is kind of a lot.
I knew you'd agree. You know what you should do? Write an article about it!
What?
You should write a piece for the paper criticising the ball. It could be just like that first one you wrote about your student job. Everyone was talking about it.
I don't know, Angela.
Oh, please. It would mean a lot to me. And... also, it's important that the town sees an outsider's perspective on this. Someone who refuses to go to balls on principle.
Sure. Fine. I'll do it.
Even as she agreed, Abigail tried, and failed, to think of a time she had told Angela she was against balls on principle.
Yay! Thank you! Thanks for doing me this little favour. I'm so glad I've got a daughter in the newspaper.
Abby?
Mia?
You said you'd be out till 3.
Yeah, well... disappointing people is what I do. Sorry, I have to get this.
Take it outside then. I'm trying to work and I can't be bothered listening to you.
Hi, India. What is it this time?
Time for you to fulfill your part of the deal.
You want me to write another article for you? Thought it was going to be more of a one-time thing.
Aw, you freshers are always so naive. It's kind of cute. Why would I call in a favor once when I can keep using it?
What do you want me to write about?
Why, Christmas ball, of course. Is anything else worth anything going on?
I can't write about the ball for you. I don't have tickets, for starters.
Would you believe it? Someone cancelled at the last minute, and now you got their pass for the ball.
You got someone to cancel? How?
Why on earth would I tell you that?
I'm not sure.
Great. So I assume you don't care if I make some calls to Angela and Mia?
Abigail was about to say that no, she didn't, but found to her surprise that wasn't true.
No, please. What do you want me to say? I can tear it down if you want.
You don't have to do that, necessarily. Just say something like, Christmas ball was good, but passé. Like, you can tell they're doing their best, but bless them, they're just not up to it. Maybe, hey, here's a thought. All the most talented events people have gravitated away from that format and towards, oh, I don't know, fashion shows. But don't make it too obvious.
But what happens if I don't think that?
No, don't think. Just do it, or there'll be consequences.
You're actually gonna do it, aren't you?
What?
That face you've got on. That's your I'm about to vent to Mia face. Well, I'm not interested.
I got Christmas ball tickets.
Must be a wrench, not being able to be all holier than thou about how you're not going then.
Truthfully, it was a bit of a wrench for Abigail not seeing Mia's eyes light up at the mention of balls, but she would never admit that.
I've never been to a ball before. I was wondering if you could—
Piss off.
I used to know how to tie this.
Oh my god, he said that?
Hey, Dana, can you help me? Oh, sorry, I didn't realize you had friends over.
Of course I do. It's the biggest night of our fresher lives. You remember Mia, right?
Oh, yeah, of course. Hi.
Hey, Josh, long time no see.
What did you need help with? I'm guessing you don't need me to zip up your dress. Unless... Joshua, you look so good in a dress! Please tell me that tuxedo is just a cover.
No, I need help tying my tie. I can't figure it out, and all the how-to videos online are impossible to follow.
Disappointing. I have no idea how to do that, actually.
Shit, I'm supposed to meet the rest of my academic family in, like, 5 minutes to pre, and I don't want to look like an idiot.
I can tie a tie.
Really?
I've dated a lot of guys who didn't know how to tie a tie either.
Oh, shoot, I left my ID in my room. I'll be right back. Joshua? Be nice.
Nina. Here, it's pretty easy. What kind of knot do you want?
There are different kinds.
I'll just do a simple one then. For future reference, you just take one and knit the tie in each hand and loop it up, down, and over, like so. And there you go, a beautiful Windsor knot.
Thank you so much. I have to dash, but it looks great.
Maybe you could repay me with a dance later tonight.
I don't know. I'll probably be with my academic family all night.
Oh, okay. Maybe I'll see you?
Yeah, maybe. Ah, shit. I really have to go.
Text conversation between Siobhan Kennedy and Abigail Bell.
Hey, you're doing Christmas ball story?
Yeah, if that's okay.
It's fine. I just think you're wasted doing events. The news section's been missing you. Your cat house review was okay, but not as good as the stuff you did earlier in the semester.
Why are you being so nice to me?
I don't do nice. I'm being honest. I know I was riding you hard earlier in the semester, but that's because I expected a lot from you. Come back to news.
I'm sorry. I can't.
Can't?
Can't because I'm enjoying events so much, I mean.
Right. Get in touch when you're done BSing me.
Here we are, boys. Christmas ball. I hope you all have rides home, because I'm going home with the lady.
I didn't know you had a date.
He doesn't. He's just got confidence.
You got that right. First run's on me, boys.
That's nice of him, to get us all drinks.
Nah, he just wants to flirt with that single girl over at the bar and look generous.
So I guess he does this a lot.
Yep.
Wow.
It's impressive, I know. It's that natural born charisma. Look, she's hanging off of every word. He's even got us under his spell. He walks away for a minute and we're all standing here talking about him.
Say what you want. I'm just waiting for those drinks.
Oh, jeez, that doesn't look good.
Is that her boyfriend, do you think?
Damn, I think he's gonna... Oh, yeah. Nathan hit him right in the jaw. Rookie mistake.
I guess he's going home alone, then.
Are you kidding? The night is young. There'll always be another one. That's the Nathan way.
Shh. He's coming back.
What I miss, lads. How about we all move on from here and check somewhere else out?
More like check someone else out.
That's what I'm talking about. Let's go.
Wow. So this is a ball.
I'm gonna go get some champagne. Want some, Dana?
Good call. This dress is cutting off circulation in some uncomfortable areas. So Mia still isn't speaking to you?
She told you about that.
She didn't have to. We don't have to talk about it, though, if you don't want to.
Thanks. It's just... I can't tell her this, but... Ugh, never mind.
Okay, then. Sorry your first ball's been such a washout, by the way. This isn't great.
I think it is. There's fairies hanging from the ceiling.
A little extra, if you ask me.
No, it's magical. Let me be excited.
All right. It's a ball. Woo! But if you want my opinion, just because you tack some garlands on the barn door doesn't mean this place isn't full of the same petty gossip, hookup, and lame drama that usually fills St. Andrews. The only difference is that we're better dressed while we do it.
Careful, if you call Abigail well-dressed, she'll tear you apart in a fit of self-righteousness.
Mia.
Let's dance, guys!
I told you I'd get things done, didn't I, Astrid?
Yeah, you were right.
The more I think about it, the more I feel like Nathan was really the only choice.
Yeah, poor Stefi, though. Those meetings are gonna be awkward.
I know, I feel bad for her because she's clearly going through something, and I want to be there for her and stuff, but it's like we're all going through our own things.
I know.
I mean, I'm running this whole committee, and it's stressful, and it's like she's not exactly there for me, and honestly, it was actually kind of selfish of her to ask me to not put Nathan on the committee.
It was?
Yeah, she was trying to put her petty relationship drama ahead of the entire committee.
Yeah, now that I think of it, you're so right. Like, we used to kind of be friends, but she hasn't texted me to hang out once lately.
It's just selfish is what it is. She's so wrapped up in the Stefi show that she doesn't think twice about anyone else, so she'll just have to deal with the Nathan thing.
You haven't told her yet, have you?
Not exactly. We kind of got into it at my Thanksgiving party, though, and we haven't talked since.
Yikes.
But she was being so crazy. She thinks I'm into Nathan or something.
Are you?
Oh my god, no! Not sure that she has the right to care anyway. She dumped him ages ago.
Why'd she dump him anyway?
Seriously, don't tell anyone. But reading between the lines, there might be a Johnny Depp situation going on.
Wait, you mean...
She didn't say it in so many words, but that's what she said.
Shit, that's crazy. Is it true, you think?
Honestly... I'm starting to feel like it's not. I mean, Nathan can be a dick sometimes, but I just don't think he's the kind of guy to do that.
I mean, Steffi's exactly the kind to make up stories.
Oh shit, be quiet, there she is.
Hey guys!
Hey!
Love your dress.
I'll see you guys later.
Oh, thanks. Listen, India, I just wanted to apologize for Thanksgiving. I was upset about a lot of stuff and had a deadline the next day, and I guess I just took it all out on you.
Don't worry about it. I think a lot of tensions were running high that night.
Right. I think anything involving Nathan still freaks me out a little. Does that make sense?
Of course, honey. I'm really sorry, too.
Can we be friends again? I really can't lose you.
Oh god, I can't lose you either.
Okay, let's just forget the whole thing.
Agreed.
Promise? You still look like something's wrong.
It's just that, with the whole Nathan thing, I have to tell you something. After we talked, I obviously dropped the idea of asking Nathan to be on the committee.
Right.
But Astrid has literally been harassing me about the whole thing, and... I think I mentioned his name to her just to, get off my back. Anyway, She just went ahead and asked him herself.
What?
And he said yes. And I'm really sorry. I know this sucks. But now that Astrid asked him, we really can't unask him?
Why not? You kicked off Angela for literally no reason.
You know that was different.
India! India. I can't be on committee with him. I thought I made that clear. How could you?
I'm really sorry. I'm really going to be there for you.
If you were there for me, you'd get him off the committee.
Steffi, don't make me choose between you and Allure. Please don't make me choose.
Just think about what you're saying for a second.
I am thinking about it. I'm thinking you broke up with a guy you say was mistreating you, and you're so obsessed with winning the breakup that you can't stand to see him doing well, too. You can't stand to see him moving on and getting involved in stuff, too, because it messes with your own twisted sense of superiority.
That's not it at all.
But I can't let your personal issues make decisions for the whole committee. And if that's what you're asking me to do, then maybe you're not taking your own position as seriously as you should.
What? Are you going to give me the boot like you did Angela?
Maybe that wouldn't be the worst thing.
I can't believe you just said that. Look, maybe we both need to cool off.
Great! Come find me when you're a real person again, instead of a shriveled up piece of Nathan's trash that thinks the whole world revolves around her.
I've always pitied you too much to hate you, India. Not anymore. Whoa, whoa, Astrid!
Oh, hey, Dana.
You're drinking a lot.
Am I? Sorry. I'm just... done.
So am I. The two people I came here with have been sniping at each other all evening, and it's pissing me off. What's up with you?
India's just done something absolutely vile to Steffi, and then used me for cover for it. But it's my fault they've fallen out, so maybe I deserve it.
Well, I'm not entirely sure who Steffi is, but I think Mia's mentioned her. You seem really cut up about this. What happened?
I can't tell you. But you were lucky not to be accepted into a law. I can't deal with this anymore. All the backstabbing and deception.
I'm sorry. You've always given off that you enjoy it.
That's why I don't drink. Alcohol makes me think honesty is a good idea.
I'm gonna assume that was a joke.
Probably fair. I'm sorry for dumping this all on you. It's not your concern. How's my favorite daughter enjoying Christmas ball?
Nah, don't change the subject.
Oh, come on, you don't want to hear about my life. It's boring.
It was at that moment that Dana realized that aside from her hatred of confrontation and almost aristocratic focus on decorum, she didn't really know much about her academic mother.
Nah, Astrid, look. Dana! Abigail, I'm kind of in the middle of something.
No. No, we're not. I'm Astrid. I don't believe we've met before.
Hi, I'm Abby. I write for The Echo. Nice to meet you. Anyway, Dana, have you seen Mia anywhere?
Oh my god, Abigail, just give her some space. If you keep following her around like a lost puppy, you're just going to annoy her more. Just go get drunk.
I can't. Got to write this review article. Anyway, it was nice meeting you, Astrid.
Is that the roommate Mia fell out with?
Yeah. I actually don't mind her, but she's apparently super focused on student journalism to the point where she was a nightmare to live with. Like, she'd get super stressed out and ignore Mia or snap at her all the time. Apparently she tried to get her to be a mole or whatever for a story Abigail was doing about Allure.
Wait, what?
I don't know. This is all stuff I've heard secondhand from Mia and my friend Claire, who was on the news team with her.
Huh. Not relevant, I suppose, but it's good to know the Echo is investigating us.
Are you going to tell India about it?
Maybe, but good to know for other reasons.
Steffi, hey, are you okay? You look like you could use some air.
What's the deal, Joshua? I thought you weren't supposed to talk to me.
Nathan's distracted. What's up?
India put Nathan on the Allure committee. I mean, she says Astrid did it, but I know that was a lie.
Did you ask her not to?
Of course!
What I mean is, did you tell her everything?
Everything? Like, the whole story? I don't think I've ever told anyone everything. But I made pretty clear what happened.
And she still didn't side with you?
Nope.
Are you gonna be okay?
I don't know.
Steph, what did you mean when you said you've never told anyone the whole story?
Oh, I just meant when I was with Nathan, things got really complicated. I never really got into it with anyone.
Why not?
No one ever asked.
I'm asking, if that's okay.
It's okay.
So, what happened?
I really fell for him. I really did. You know, I'd never really had a boyfriend before. But Nathan was everything I imagined it should be. He took me to the beach on our first date. We ended up talking for so many hours it got dark, and then it was like when he held my hand, I got goosebumps, and when he kissed me, well, I don't know, we just couldn't stop. We had chemistry, you know, crazy chemistry. I really thought...
Thought what?
Nothing, Josh. Do you believe in soulmates?
No, I don't think so. Not anymore.
I probably shouldn't, but I can't help it. The thing I keep wondering is, what if you found your soulmate and they end up being a total asshole? What are you supposed to do then?
So he became an asshole.
I mean, it just got hard. We got into something so intense so quickly, we were both a little freaked out about losing it.
He got jealous?
We both did. He could always be a bit of a flirt, and when I saw him talking to other girls, it made me want to throw up. And then I'd go out of my way to talk to other guys in front of him, and that obviously drove him crazy.
Oh, man.
We even broke up a few times, but we were always back together within the week. Being together was intense, but being apart, for us, it was just unrealistic.
It doesn't sound very healthy.
Maybe it wasn't. Maybe some people are just bad at being in love. And then, at the beginning of this year, I...
It's okay. You don't need to say it if you don't want to.
No. No, it's okay. Someone should know. In September, I found out I was pregnant.
Are you serious?
Unfortunately. I didn't tell anyone. I thought that if I didn't say it out loud, it'd be like it wasn't real. But that's not really the way things work. I took the bus to Dundee alone, went to the clinic, and I thought that would erase the whole thing. No one had to know. Only...
You don't have to.
Only when I got home that day, I couldn't stop crying. I was hysterical. Nathan freaked out, demanded to know what was wrong, and he insisted that someone hurt me, that he was going to beat them up.
Yeah, that sounds like Nathan.
So I told him the truth. God, his face turned white. I couldn't tell if he was shocked or angry or embarrassed, but it was like he just hated everyone who hurt me. And then he hated me because I hurt myself. Can you imagine Nathan as a dad?
Yeah, a bit.
Oh, I forgot. But yeah, you can see why. It just would have been a bad situation. And I thought I was fixing it. But he just looked so broken. And we started fighting. And you know he has a temper.
That's when he hit you for the first time.
He was so mad. He had this book on his desk, and he threw it across the room. I don't think he meant for it to hit me.
But it did.
Square in the jaw. He hated himself for it. I didn't tell anyone, because I always felt like it was kind of my fault. We fought like that for a few weeks. I couldn't blame him. I was the one that broke us. That broke our family.
You didn't do anything wrong.
Maybe that's true. But from here, it feels like I didn't do anything right. When I looked at him, all I could see was how much he hurt me and how much I hurt him. And he knew it. We both did. You don't get past something like this.
Oh, God. Is there anything I can do?
No, I don't think so. Sorry to dump this all on you, God. I'm usually more put together than this. Just that committee thing really threw me.
What are you gonna do?
What I always do. Put on a brave face. You should get back before Nathan starts wondering about you. I'll be okay.
There are other guys.
Oh, I don't know about that. Once you love someone, anything else kind of tastes like stale toast.
I'm sorry.
We all are. That's kind of what it's like living in St. Andrews. Your ghosts are just everywhere. In the cupboard underneath the stairs, steps stamp on above my head.
Maybe you're cruel to me, but you see, I love it when you make me plead. I want a scar that looks just like you. Till then, I gotta learn to be a wiser fool. Baby, you need to leave, and I know you know. That's why you keep ignoring me. Because if you don't, gonna run me down, let myself go.
This episode of Citizens of Nowhere was written by Jamie Rodney and Hermione Bird, and edited by Claire Fenerty and Jamie Rodney. Sophia Anderson played Abigail Bell, Anna South played Stefi Warrack and Dana Richardson. Jamie Rees was Joshua Braze, as an understudy for Sang of Steel. Holly Scrivener was Astrid Bracken, Lucy Beal Lott was India Rayner, Ellie Laurence was Angela Murray. Katherine Montana was Mia Bridge, Alana Foster was Siobhan Kennedy, Andrew Johnson was Nathan Livingstone, Nathan Lovelace was Ethan Paterson and Will Balfour. The narrator was played by me, Kiera Obi.